is a download of the Montage Film Review Sunday DVD Rental Suggestion Podcast, the first edition of our third year of broadcasting, and so begins a month of what I will term mindfuck movies. The first installment on this trip is Alan Parker's Angel Heart, a movie set in New York City and New Orleans in 1955, in which Harold Angel is a private detective who is hired to find a shell-shocked soldier who went missing around 12 years earlier owing his client a debt. Despite telling his client that he tries to never get involved in anything too heavy, he finds himself surrounded by dead bodies and wonders if perhaps somebody is trying to set him up. What's more, it seems that there is a lot of religion and voodoo practices and habits intertwined with the case, which is increasingly involving the police, who see Angel as a suspect. He tries to back out of the job, but his client, one Louis Cyphre, played by Robert De Niro, increases the payout on it. So, by calling in a few favours and making good use of several fake IDs, Angel focuses on the job at hand, finding Johnny Favourite, a crooner who had some successes before America's entry into the Second World War. It seems that after being sent to Africa to entertain the troops leaves him badly injured, he is returned home but cannot remember who he is. A long stint in the hospital does not rectify this issue, and he subsequently goes missing from said hospital with a little help from his friends. He is now a ghost. He is out there in the world with amnesia, not knowing that people are looking for him. The friends who discharged him from the hospital had then dumped him in Times Square on New Year's Eve in an attempt to jolt his memory back into place. This would have been the last place he would remember before heading off to war. But they end up losing him in the crowds. In his wake, he had left several broken hearts, a daughter, and a lot of fear to round off the debt he owes to Angel's client, who is becoming increasingly impatient. Now, this film is listed as a masterpiece edition because it is the complete package. Everything works. The script is based on the novel Falling Angel by William Hjortsberg, which you can purchase by visiting the podcast section of the website. The soundtrack includes original music played by Courtney Pine, as well as classic jazz by the likes of Dr. John from the psychedelic era and rhythm and blues singer Laverne Baker, who had her successes during the 1950s. Alan Parker is one of the finest living directors, in my opinion. This is the man who brought us Mississippi Burning, Bugsy Malone, and Fame. I don't understand why his filmography is so short. If you subscribe to the Montage Film Reviews newsletter, you would have heard me say on several occasions that the script is the most important thing in filmmaking, as this is the foundation of everything else in the production. I haven't read the book yet, but I know my two most famous lines are taken straight out of it. These are, "How terrible is wisdom when it brings no profit to the wise, Johnny?" And, "However carefully you sneak up on a mirror, your reflection always looks you straight in the eye." This is why Montage Film Reviews likes to give equal billing to the literature that many a movie has sprung from. If you are a filmmaker yourself, be sure to visit the Literature Archive section of the blog for work that is now in the public domain and use it for inspiration. This, I think, will be especially useful for short film makers, because many a short film has been rejected for review on the site because, although it has been well made, there is no story to speak of. I'm your host, Shay Trinity. This has been an Eskimo Fin production. Follow me on Twitter, I am at Eskimo Fin, and while you're over in the blog archives, check out the short film review archive. Until next time.